During today's parliament sitting, the deputy speaker Thomas Tayewa named a seven-member committee chaired by Mbara South MP Mwine Mpaka to investigate allegations of misconduct against the state minister for housing, Persis Namganza, and other ingredients in the censure motion to determine whether there is a prima facie case against the embattled minister.
It has to be thoroughly done. We don't want anyone to claim I'm being victimized because of A, B, C, D, so and so. No. This is within the rules. Whatever is being done is being done because the rules and the law provides for that.
The House approved the select committee, and Tayewa asked the committee to report back within 15 days. The speaker forwarded the motion and other supporting documents on the minister's misconduct to the committee. It should be noted that Mpaka, who has been appointed to chair the select committee against Namganza, chaired the trade committee which investigated the controversial coffee agreement of Uganda Vinci Coffee Company and recommended its termination.
What the speaker did was comply with the law. You cannot prosecute someone without giving that person the right to defend himself or herself. So the committee will listen to the accused person so that you hear the other side. Maybe in the process of hearing the other side, the person can be exonerated, or the person can ask for forgiveness and the matter is settled.
Tayewa said he transmitted the motion of censure to the president on 23rd December, and the House had to sit today after 14 days to constitute a select committee, as the procedure of censuring a minister provides.
We did our part as per the rules. And in this process where we've reached, we are being commanded by the law. It's not being commanded by someone talking to me, by someone whispering. It's implementing the law the way it is. Okay? And I will follow the law the way it is. I'll follow the rules the way they are, because under Rule 109, sub-rule 9, it's very clear that within 14 days, after 14 days of transmitting it to the president, I must cause parliament to sit and appoint a select committee that will investigate the minister with the aim of establishing a prima facie case.
He explained that although the law provides that the speaker writes to the president, it does not provide for the president to respond to parliament on what to do with the censure of the minister. He insisted that no one can direct parliament on what to do with the censure other than the law.
The moment we transmit it to the president, we have served the minister. The president has no role, is not required to be writing back. That's what the law says. So we did our part. We hope the president has done his part. But also the committee is required to ensure that they invite the Honorable Persis Namganza to come and appear, so that she can be listened to and she gives her side.
Tayewa informed parliament that all timelines provided in the censure process of the minister are going to be observed to the later, and the House convened on 23rd exactly after 15 days to receive the select committee report, debate the matter and vote on the motion of censure.
Tentatively, I can say on the 23rd of January, we shall be having a sitting whereby we shall receive the report of the committee and we vote on it, and that would be the final stage of processing this petition.
MPs have welcomed the committee with expectations that it will give the minister a right to a fair hearing.
It is optional. She may appear before the committee to defend herself, but I don't see her defending herself and they are exonerating her. I don't see exoneration there. Then they will come with a report. We shall thoroughly debate it in parliament and we shall show our exit, because we must show that this parliament is a biting dog.
I know that there are issues leading to the censure of Honorable Namganza. However, those issues are not very clear. So my expectations from the committee, first and foremost, is to make those issues very clear so that they are clearly known, and to give weight to those issues, to convince us that those issues are of weight, that is of a level of actually censuring a minister.
According to Rule 109 of the Parliamentary Rules of Procedure, Upon receipt of the committee's report, the Speaker shall call upon the Chief Petitioner to open debate on the motion, followed by a defense by the concerned minister and a debate by the House. The House shall then vote on the motion, and if carried by more than half of all the voting members of Parliament, the Speaker shall inform the President of this fact within 24 hours from the time the motion was voted upon. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.